that in repentance and rest is your only hope. The only hope left for the church is to return to him with all their heart and to get out of Egypt and the world.
Unless I am so convinced that I am wrong, I am bound to my beliefs by the texts of the Bible. My conscience is captive to the word of God. To go against conscience is neither right nor safe.
It's hard to keep up with Sam Smith's identities, but last night's Grammys, they, as Smith now prefers to be called, identified as Satan. The performance riled many views, especially amongst the American Christian fraternity, which there are 210 million in America. Senator Ted Cruz said it was evil.
Well, how could a society say men give birth? You can't get more absurd. It is not possible. And half the society now believes that. We are living in an age of chaos, pure chaos. The left is living and creating chaos. Men give birth. You know, a Norwegian lesbian is now on trial in Norway for saying men cannot be lesbians. She faces a 3-year sentence of hate speech for saying men cannot be lesbians. You know how sick that is? Men can be lesbians? Are you out of your minds? Yes, they are. We are living in the age of chaos, and you know what produces it? Of course, the left does, but something deeper, secularism. A lot of you may not be religious, but I need you to understand something. The post-Judeo-Christian world is a world of chaos. That is inevitable. Inevitable.
What is the hardest thing about being a Christian teenager?
Not compromising your faith for friendship.
If you tell people in school, yeah, they'll probably think you're weird, innit?
Sharing the word of God because people will think that, oh, you're trying to offend my faith.
Not conforming to the ways of the world, which is obviously going to be tough when the whole world disagrees with you.
Just having so many opinions being spoken over me from like friends at school, from people at church, and it was just this constant battle of being, well, what do I actually believe and what do I actually mean in this world?
The Bible is true in a very strange way. It's true in that it provides the basis for truth itself. And so it's like a meta-truth.
Only 2% of churches. This is hard to believe. A recent survey done by the American Culture and Faith Institute interviewed churches across the nation and asked them very basic questions about doctrine. Did Jesus live a sinless life? Is Satan real or imaginary? 70% of the churches surveyed did not line up with the basic teachings of the Bible, which leaves only 100,000 churches in America who believe the core teachings of the Word of God. But of those 100,000 churches, when asked, do you preach these things? Do you teach these things? Only 2% said that they will teach those things from Scripture, that they will teach what the Bible teaches because they don't want to offend their congregants. They're not going to preach and teach what the Bible says about the current issues of the day. Only 2% of churches in America are actually preaching relevant messages from the Word of God to our culture. We need a revival.
Why is every other religion accepted except Christianity? Let me tell you why. Every other religion is very broad. Christianity is very narrow. Teach Dr. Phil. You see, there's a pluralistic approach that why can't we all get along because all roads lead to heaven? That's not true. Jesus makes it too specific. And that's why you can wear a shirt with Islam, with all kind of religion, and it's tolerated at your workplace. The minute you try to wear the cross or you bring Jesus in there, they say, don't bring that Jesus stuff in here because Jesus is a threat. See, churches don't preach Jesus anymore. We preach 7 steps to success. We preach 7 habits of highly successful people. We preach how to unlock the secret of heaven. But can we back to preaching Jesus? Because Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no man comes to the Father except but through. People said that there's many ways to get to heaven because all religions are the same. No, all religions are not the same. Every religion preaches something, but Jesus preaches the only thing, which is I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no man gets to the Father except but through me.
Hey.
And I look at the whole religious scene today, and all I see are the inventions and ministries of man and flesh. It's mostly powerless. It has no impact on the world. And I see more of the world coming into the church and impacting the church rather than the church impacting the world. I see the music taking over the house of God. I see entertainment taking over the house of God. An obsession with entertainment in God's house, a hatred of correction and a hatred of reproof. Nobody wants to hear it anymore. Whatever happened to anguish in the house of God? Whatever happened to anguish in the ministry? It's a word you don't hear in this pampered age. You don't hear it. Anguish means extreme pain and distress. The emotion so stirred that it becomes painful. Acute, deeply felt inner pain because of conditions about you, in you or around you. Anguish. Deep pain. Deep sorrow. Agony of God's heart. We've held on to our religious rhetoric and our revival talk, but we've become so passive. All true passion is born out of anguish. All true passion for Christ comes out of a baptism of anguish. You search the scripture and you'll find that when God determined to recover a ruined situation, he would share his own anguish for what God saw happening to his church and to his people.